Hi, hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. Today we are going to solve this data production superbatch unit. And to unlock this superbatch, we need to complete these two prerequisites. And if you complete these two, then the data production superbatch unit will get unlocked. And to start this challenge, we need to sign up for the developer edition or for that click on this link. So here is the sign up form. So fill all the details available here and enter the first name. And also enter the last name. And now type your own email address. So you will get the password reset email for this email. So keep check that email. And then select the role as developer and type the company name as your college name or Salesforce. And then select the country. After that, type your postal code. And then set the username for this superbatch unit. So I'm setting it as dataprotection@educationmatters.com. So check it whether it is available or not. So yeah, it is available. And then click on this checkbox and then click on this sign me up button. So here we can see that please check your email to confirm your new account. And to receive the email, it takes approximately 10 to 15 minutes of time. Wait until that. So after waiting for 10 minutes of time, I got this email that is welcome to Salesforce, verify your account. So click on this verify account. So here click on this reset password. Now click OK. And here set your own password. And then confirm the password that you entered. After that, type the answer for your security question and then click on this change password button. So yeah, we can see that the password is resetted successfully. Just close this tab and then from this email, copy the username available here and move to the instruction space. Scroll down to the last and here click on these three dots and then click on this connect org button. Now paste the username which you copied earlier and then type the password. After that, click on this login button. So here click OK and then click Allow. And finally click on this S Save It button. Just scroll down to the last. And here we can see that the hands-on org is added successfully. And let's move to the challenge one. The challenge one is data leakage quiz. So click on this take quiz button. And then here click on this accept. So the first question is, which end user permission is associated with the highest risk for data leakage? And the correct option is option C. And the next question, which permission grants access to Salesforce records through an API integration? And the correct option is option B. And the third question, how should an admin limit the data that a connected app may access in Salesforce? And the correct option is option A, OAuth tokens and scopes. And the fourth question, what should be used to scramble sensitive data in a full sandbox environment? And the correct option is option B, data masking. And the last question, which data leakage threat is impossible to eliminate? And the correct option is option D. So like this, we selected all the five answers and then click on this check the quiz button. So yeah, we got 400 points. Now in this video, we are going to solve the challenge 2 in data production superbatch unit. And the name of the challenge is identify data loss and restore the data. So to start this challenge, we need to launch the developer edition org. For that, click on this launch button. Then you will be redirected to this page. So now let's move to the instructions. So here are the instructions that they given. So what is there in these instructions is someone is changed the emails to wrongly entered emails. And we need to identify that user. And also we need to change all the wrong email IDs to the correct email IDs. So let's start this task. So move to the setup page and from this launcher icon, search for sales. So click on the sales. So from here move to these contacts, and from this my contacts we can see that there are approximately 110 contacts available here. So we need to check each and every one which are available here, but it's not possible. So first of all, let's check who changed the email IDs. So for that, click on this contact name, and here in this contact history we can see that the user marketing integration user is changed from original value email ID to this new value email ID. So at this top we can see this search button, click on that, and from this search all, select it as people, and here in this search, search for marketing integration user. So click on this marketing integration user. So we can see that this user has changed the wrongly entered emails. So it's not possible to replace all the correct emails for all the 110 contacts. So I have written the code here. I will give this link in the description, and also I will paste this code in the comments also. So copy from there. So what we need to do is, from here click on this setup icon, and here click on this developer console, just right click, and then click on this open link in new tab. So here we can see that the developer console page is available, and here click on this debug, and from here click on this open execute anonymous window. So now copy the code which I have given and then paste the code here, and after that here I have leave it as your marketing user ID. So we need to replace this. Just remove this and move to this page, and here at the top of the URL after this user slash there are some numbers and the letters. Just copy all of them and then paste it over here. So after pasting the marketing user ID, just click on this execute. So we can see that the status is success. That means we changed all the email IDs to the correct email IDs. So move to the instruction space, scroll down to the last, and then click on this check challenge button. So yeah, we got 400 points. That means we completed the challenge without any errors. Now in this video, we are going to solve the challenge 3 in data production superbatch unit, and the name of the challenge is prevent and protect against data loss. To start this challenge, launch the developer edition org, then you will be redirected to this setup page. So let's move to the instructions. So here are the instructions that we need to complete. So move to the setup page, and in this quick find search for data export. So click on this data export. So here click on this schedule export. For this end date, it should be selected as August and something the date like 15. And after that, for this preferred start time, selected as 12 a.m. And finally click on this save button. So here it is. And after that, remove this and then search for permission sets. So click on this permission sets, and here click on this M letter, and from here click on this marketing integration user, and from now click on this object settings. So in this find settings, search for contacts. So here it is, click on this contacts. So click edit, scroll down, and for this email, deselect this edit access, and then click on the save button. So we completed the challenge, scroll down to the last, and then click on this check challenge button. So yeah, we got 500 points. we are going to solve the last and final challenge in this data production super batch unit. So scroll down to the last, and the name of the challenge is data preservation quiz. So click on this take quiz button. And the first question is, which of these tools can be used to automatically backup files attached to records? And the correct option is option B. And the next question, what is a data retention policy? And the correct option is option D. The third question, how often should org data be backed up? And the correct option is option A. The fourth question is, what happens when you truncate a custom object? And the correct option is option D. And the last and final question is, in addition to the Salesforce data export service, which of the following options can be used to automatically backup Salesforce org data at regular intervals? And the correct option is option A, dataloader.io. So after selecting all of these answers, just click on this check the quiz button. So yeah, we complete the whole data production super batch unit without any errors. And please do check out our channel Education Matters for next super batch answers and also next module answers. And please do share our channel to your friends. It will help them too. That's it. Thank you.